It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Beautiful day for a neighbor. Could you be my? Could you be my? Won't you be? Won't you be? Please, won't you be my neighbor? Da da da. Da 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 da. Please, won't you be? Of course, there's a good chance you already are, my neighbor, since I own so many homes. Da, da, da. It is a beautiful day. Thank you, Manuel. Hello, neighbor. You see this? It's called a wallet. And inside of a wallet, well, that's where money goes. Now, do you know what money is? I'm guessing no, because you're watching public television. Therefore, you don't have cable. Therefore, you're probably poor. Money is sort of like paper that you can use to buy things that you want, like toys or yachts. Now, you may be wondering, where does money come from? Well, it comes from a magical place called our parents. Uh-oh, there's somebody at the door. I wonder who it could be. Oh, it's a good friend, Mr. Obama.
Hey, hello, Mr. Romney.
Hello, Mr. Obama. You remember Mr. Obama, right? Last week at the debate, Mr. Obama taught us all a new word, choke. What brings you to the neighborhood today?
Well, since my sleepy performance at the debate, Mr. Romney, my wife Michelle has insisted that I pick up some new job skills. So I'm now a mailman part-time. And, oh, look here, special delivery. October jobs report. And the unemployment numbers are down. So, in your face.
That's just wonderful. Did you know that Mr. Obama is the President of the United States? It's a very important job. You have to make big decisions, and you're in charge of a lot of people for 4 years.
Mr. Romney, I think you made a mistake. I think you mean 8 years.
You see, kids, Mr. Obama just did something called using your imagination.
Actually, if you take a look at the polls, I think you'll see that in a number of the key states, there's...
It's fun to use your imagination. You know, I love to have fun and laugh, ha, ha, ha. With an imagination, why, the simple piece of string here, it could be any number of things. It can't be that. It could be anything. It could be, that doesn't make any sense. It could be a piece of twine. Actually, no, twine and string are two fundamentally different things, but you know what, this is stupid. So who even... Oh, hey, look, it's the trolley. It's on the way to the neighborhood of make-believe. That's where me and Paul Ryan get most of our facts from. Let's hop aboard, shall we? I think today I'll bring my trusty friend, Mr. Dog. Hi, Mr. Dog, want to go for a trip? You do? Great. Just make sure that you're on good and tight here. Make sure you're on all right. Okay. Off we go. The neighborhood of make-believe. A land full of things that don't exist in the real world. Look, there's a talking cat in a treehouse. And hey, look over there. It's my tax returns. Hello, Henrietta. Now, kids, don't be alarmed. This puppet feline isn't real. Look. This is Bill. He's a union worker. You pay him with your tax dollars so that he can crouch down with the sock in his hand and make silly voices. You disgust me. Well, that's all the time we have today on Mr. Romney's Neighborhood. But before I go, remember, there's only one person in the world that's like you, and that's you. And people can like you exactly the way you are. But if they don't, then just pretend to be the exact opposite of what you are, and then maybe they'll like you.
Yeah, but doesn't that sort of undermine your original...
Bill, you're fired. I'll be back next time. Bye-bye.